morning in family time, the holiday season is coming up quickly, and already parents and family members may be struggling to come up with the perfect gifts. Joining us today with a positive parenting look at gift giving is Amy McCready, founder of PositiveParentingSolutions.com and author of a book whose title I love, If I Have to Tell You One More Time. Amy, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me, Michaela.
I love the title of your book. We're going to talk more about that in just a second. But you mentioned that it's very important for parents to get a little more creative with their gift giving.
Yes. In fact, I work with parents of toddlers to teens, and I really recommend that parents kind of mix it up, because we want gifts that are going to inspire our kids' imagination, we want to foster a love of learning, and we want it to just be fun so we can play with our kids and emotionally connect with them. That's good for kids and for parents.
So do you have any advice then for anyone trying to choose a gift that will have a good influence on a child?
Yes. In fact, you know, one of the best things that we can do with our kids is help them with their reading. So one of the educational gifts that I really recommend this year is from Rosetta Stone. Rosetta Stone, of course, is the leader in online language learning. And this year they've introduced their first ever kids reading program for kids ages 3 to 7. So want to check that out. The other thing that I recommend for younger kids to really encourage free play and storytelling is the Sago Mini Plush Toys. These were actually inspired by the Sago Mini Suite of apps, and very, very popular with preschoolers and toddlers. And just like their digital counterparts, these Sago plush characters are just simple toys. They encourage storytelling, and kids just love to have fun with them.
Very cute for the little ones. And moving on now, as kids get a little bit older, I know they're all into games. Do you have anything there?
Yes, well, gaming is always hot, and I encourage parents to go to GameStop. It is the place to go for all of your gaming and tech items. And, you know, they have pre-owned and new items. They have layaway, a buyback program, so all of the tools that parents need to get everything on their wish list. This year at GameStop, is the really hot item is the Eons Elite Trigger Happy figure. Super popular, part of the Skylanders universe, and kids love that. And of course, GameStop has all sorts of games for other age groups as well. And I also encourage kids and everyone really to make their own wish lists. Mm-hmm. And this year, I'm stealing an idea from Amazon.com. You can go to Amazon.com/nudge and actually nudge your kids, your family members, nieces and nephews to create their own wish list. They can put anything on that wish list. It's super handy, even items that are from a totally different website. So that's a great idea to make shopping a lot easier.
Very clever. And before we let you go really quickly, let's go back to your book. Do you have any secrets for getting children to do as they're told without, you know, facing all of those battles between child and parent?
Yes, three things, particularly during the holidays. First, one-on-one time with your kids. Spend time playing with them, because it actually makes them better behaved. Number two, stick to the routines, especially during the holiday chaos. And third, we want to put some gratitude in their attitude. But there are a lot more tips, and you can find ideas on all of these things by going to tipsontv.com.
All right, Amy, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me, Michaela.
All right, if you missed any of those tips that Amy mentioned, head on over to WPRI.com, where we'll post a link to her website.